study about the hypothalamus and pituitary gland in detail with respect to the secretion of the hormones. Now, what is a hypothalamus? Hypothalamus is a part of the brain which is located below the thalamus region, and hence below thalamus, hence it is a hypothalamus. Now, hypothalamus, this part, this area is a hypothalamus, and the pituitary gland which is attached to this hypothalamus by a stalk, so that is called as a infundibulum. So this particular part is a pituitary gland and which is attached to the hypothalamus by the infundibulum. Now pituitary gland basically is divided into two lobes. It is an anterior lobe and the posterior lobe. Anterior lobe jyada bada hota hai. So out of the total pituitary gland, 75% is the anterior lobe of the pituitary gland and 25% is the posterior lobe of the pituitary gland. Now anterior lobe of the pituitary gland is called as adenohypophysis. Posterior lobe is called as neurohypophysis, or it is also called as pars distalis, and this is pars nervosa. Now anterior lobe and posterior lobe ka origin bhi different hai. Anterior lobe is endodermal in origin, whereas posterior lobe is ectodermal in origin. So overall, pituitary gland is ecto-endodermal in origin. This is very important, please remember ki pituitary gland is ecto-endodermal in origin. Now the ye kahan se origin hota hai? So this is the outgrowth of pharynx. In case of embryo, when the embryo is there in the mother's womb, so embryo ka jo pharynx ka pouch hota hai, that is called as a Ratke's pouch. So uska outgrowth is this adenohypophysis, and this is a downgrowth of the hypothalamus, and then later on this part get joined. So pharynx ki wahan pe nahi rehta hai, it goes into the below hypothalamus. So what we learn, hypothalamus ke niche pituitary gland hai, that is joined to the pituitary gland. Hypothalamus ko pituitary gland infundibulum se join hua hai. Anterior lobe is called as adenohypophysis, or it is a pars distalis. Posterior lobe is a neurohypophysis, or it is pars nervosa. And the intermediate lobe, this intermediate lobe is a pars intermedia. Now the hormone secreted from this hypothalamus and pituitary gland is very interesting phenomenon. Listen it carefully. Hypothalamus is called as a supreme commander. That means hypothalamus is releasing certain factors which are called as a releasing factor. Now in the anterior lobe and in the posterior lobe, this secretion of hormone is a altogether different process. Remember, there are this N1 nerve is going into the anterior lobe of the pituitary gland, and N2 nerve is going to the posterior lobe of the pituitary gland. Now there are the neurosecretory cells. These are the neurons. Actually, I have drawn this way, and this is a particular structure of the neuron. So these are the neurosecretory cells. Neurosecretory cells, yahan pe kya karenge? The neurosecretory cells which are present in the hypothalamus, that will release a hormone. These are called as a hormone releasing factor. So please remember, these are called as a hormone releasing factor. Now this hormone releasing factor will go into the hypophyseal portal circulation. This will go into the hypophyseal portal circulation. So hypophyseal portal circulation mein ye sab releasing factor yahan pe jo dot dikh rahe, so all these are the releasing factor released into the hypophyseal portal circulation. Now ye releasing factor will come into the anterior lobe of the pituitary gland via this portal circulation, and in the anterior lobe of the pituitary gland, these releasing factors are offloaded. Wo yahan pe chhod denge, anterior lobe mein all releasing factor will arise, yahan pe aayenge, and this, under the stimulation of this releasing factor, anterior lobe of pituitary gland will secrete a hormone which are called as a trophic hormone. Now trophic hormone kya hota hai? Trophic hormone are secreted from one endocrine gland, and it is stimulating the other endocrine gland to secrete their hormone. This is a procedure only in case of the adenohypophysis or anterior lobe of pituitary gland. There will be the neurosecretory cell in the hypothalamus. Wo neurosecretory cell releasing factor release karenge in hypophyseal portal circulation. Hypophyseal portal circulation mein all this releasing factor will be given into the anterior lobe of pituitary gland, and when the command their hormone. Now, so hypothalamus is called as a supreme commander and pituitary gland, it is called as a master endocrine gland. Hypothalamus is a supreme commander and pituitary gland is a master endocrine gland because it is stimulating the other endocrine gland to secrete their hormone as it is releasing a trophic hormone. Now, in case of the posterior lobe of the pituitary gland, the mechanism is little different. In the posterior lobe of the pituitary gland, these are the neurosecretory cell and the axon terminal of the neurosecretory cell are synthesizing the hormone. So, two very important hormones in this is ADH and oxytocin. So, it is ADH and oxytocin. These are the two very important hormones. Remember, two terms here, synthesized in the axon terminal by the hypothalamus. Hypothalamus mein jo neurosecretory cell honge, unke axon terminal will synthesize these two hormones, ADH and oxytocin. And these hormones will be secreted just by the posterior lobe of pituitary gland. So posterior lobe just ek madhyam hai, jahan se ye hormone release honge. Posterior lobe iska koi preparation nahi karega ye hormone ka. Prepare kahan pe ho rahe ho? In the neurosecretory cells of hypothalamus. Axon terminal wo sab release karenge and it will just carry or it will be just secreted from the posterior lobe of the pituitary gland. Ye dhyan mein rakho. So axon terminal yahan pe hormone release kar rahe aur yahan pe releasing factor hai jo hypophysial portal circulation mein jaake trophic hormone ko banane ke liye help karta hai, matlab command deta hai trophic hormone abhi aap ko ready hona padega. Ye command is given by releasing factor and fir trophic hormone will stimulate the other gland to secrete their hormone. As an example yahan pe maine TSH likha hai. Supposing a kind of trophic hormone called as thyroid stimulating hormone. Thyroid stimulating hormone will go on the target organ, that is a thyroid gland. And now thyroid gland will synthesize its hormone like thyroxine. So that is the process how the thyroxine is secreted. Now hence hypothalamus is a supreme commander and pituitary gland is called as a master endocrine gland. Now hypophysis ne yahan pe, this is a hypothalamus. So hypothalamus is secreting a releasing factor. So this is a hypothalamus that is secreting certain releasing factor. So this is a TSH, thyroid stimulating releasing factor, adrenocorticotropic releasing factor, follicle stimulating and luteinizing hormone release factor, prolactin release as well as inhibitory factor, growth hormone release as well as inhibitory factor. Remember, hypothalamus will produce a releasing factor as well as inhibitory factor. Releasing factor will help anterior pituitary gland to release a trophic hormone as well as by feedback mechanism it will also inhibit the synthesis of the particular hormone. So that is what is a hypothalamus. So all these are the releasing factors that will go into the anterior lobe of the pituitary gland. So under the TSH releasing factor, anterior lobe of pituitary gland will secrete TSH, thyroid stimulating hormone, and that will go to the target organ thyroid. So this is a target organ and it will release the hormone thyroxine or thyrocalcitonin. Now ACTH, adrenocorticotropic hormone, trophic hormone, that means secreted from one endocrine gland and it helps to release the hormone of other endocrine gland. So adrenocorticotropic hormone, it will go on the adrenal gland and it will release glucocorticoid and mineral corticoid from the adrenal cortex. Adrenaline will not be secreted under the ACTH. So it will secrete glucocorticoid and mineral corticoid under the stimulation of ACTH from the adrenal cortex of adrenal gland. Follicle stimulating hormone, in case of male, it will act on the testes to secrete the sperm. So seminiferous tubule of the testes under the influence of FSH hormone will secrete or will start producing sperms. And in case of female, in the ovary it will produce ova and the hormone estrogen. Now ICSH, intercortical stimulating hormone, again it will go into the male sex organ to release a hormone testosterone and luteinizing hormone in case of female that will release progesterone. Prolactin will act on the mammary gland milk from the mammary gland after parturition. Growth hormone, that is a growth hormone releasing factor that will produce a hormone that is called as a somatostatin. So it is a somatostatin. And growth hormone, which is a somatotropic hormone, it will act on overall body tissues to produce help the body tissues to grow. So that is the hormone releasing factor which are acting on the anterior lobe of the pituitary gland, and the hormone secreted from this anterior lobe of the pituitary gland, they are going on the target organ to secrete the hormone from that particular target organ. Now in the posterior lobe of the pituitary gland, as I already said, the axon terminal are releasing this hormone. So posterior lobe of pituitary gland, in the neurosecretory cell, hormones are synthesized and just released from the posterior pituitary gland, that is the ADH and oxytocin. So that is about the hypothalamus and pituitary gland and the connection of hypothalamus and the pituitary gland.